Hey everyone, this is Nick, and I'm jumping on today to show you this fun circular bar chart. It's kind of an alternative to a traditional bar chart, but I will say that you should probably use these charts sparingly because they do sort of distort the data. So the inner ring is always going to look shorter than the outer ring, and even if that outer ring there, you can see here in this 95%, this 95% ring, even if this was like maybe 50% or 60%, it might still show up longer than this inner, the inner ring here. Even if that inner ring was 100%, it would just go down to this sort of half circle point here. So this is just a fun chart type. I've seen it a lot in different infographics. And so just make sure that you're using this chart type responsibly and making sure that your audience will appreciate it and understand it if you're going to use it. And I'm gonna show you how to make this really quickly in PowerPoint. We're just gonna do this with manipulating a donut chart here. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna insert a chart in PowerPoint. Go to the pie section here and then the donut section, and we're gonna click OK, and this gives you the stock donut chart there. The data source pops up here. I'm gonna go ahead right away and delete the row 4 and 5. We don't need those series of data for this. And then I'm gonna go ahead and just kind of update this. This is gonna be called group 1. And I'm gonna put 100% there, and then I'm gonna put 100% in this row right here, and this is, I'm just gonna call this half circle. And then this row is going to be for my data here. Okay, now let's go ahead and make some adjustments to the chart. We're gonna get rid of the title and we're gonna get rid of the legend. And now if I would like to add more series of data to this donut chart, let's just go ahead and say group 2, group 3, oops, go ahead, I'm just gonna spell this out, group 3, and group 4. And this is a dynamic table in Excel, so you can see that it's sort of updating as we go. I'm gonna go ahead and just type in my percentages here now. So for that group 1, we had 95%, and then group 2, we had 50%, group 3, we had 34%, and group 4, we have 25%, and then I'm just going to add 100% along each of the half circle columns. And now you can see our racing, our circular donut chart here is sort of taking shape. Let's go ahead and close this data source for now, and let's go ahead. The first thing I wanna do is make the bars wider. So what we do there is highlight any circle there, go to the Format Series menu over here, the little bar chart. Under Donut Hole Size, we're gonna decrease that. Just go ahead and decrease it to what you think it looks best as. I'm gonna actually decrease it all the way to 30% in this case. Then what we want to do is we want to get rid of these orange series. So we want to make those no fill. So go ahead and isolate each one by double clicking and then pushing that paint can button and then pushing no fill. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to isolate the next one and push F4. That's going to repeat the same formatting. F4. And then F4, and now we have our donut chart. Now you see, you do notice that we have our series sort of flopped from the one that I did over here, but we can go ahead and sort the data series by doing this. We're gonna go ahead and insert, or right click, click on edit data, and then the next thing that you wanna do is click on this little Excel icon right here. This is gonna open the data source in a clean new Excel file that you can then sort your data and manipulate that there. So right here, the first thing, we know that this is a dynamic table because of this little caret right here. What we wanna do is get rid of that dynamic table formatting. So I'm gonna highlight, actually I'll just highlight the entire table right here, go up to the Table Design tab, and then click on Convert to Range. This just converts everything to a range of cells, and we're gonna go ahead and say yes. And now I can go ahead and sort all of these. I can sort them left to right instead of up and down. So let's go ahead and just highlight everything that I wanna sort. I'm gonna right click and click on sort, and then go to custom sort there. The first thing you need to do is click on this options button, and instead of top to bottom, I'm gonna say left to right. And now we're gonna go ahead, we're gonna sort by row 2, and I'm gonna say smallest to largest. Now you can see everything has sort of updated their smallest to largest. I'm gonna close this right here. And now you can see our circular bar chart has reformatted itself, kind of sorted itself so that that group one now is on the top, and then it goes down in sort of descending order. Now there's not really easy way to label these over here, like you see right here, group one, group two, group three, group four. So we're gonna do this with brute force. We're just gonna sort of add a text box here. And we're gonna use some shortcuts to make this a little faster. So we're gonna first insert a text box, and I really like to use Open Sans Condensed right here for these labels. I'm gonna right align this, and I'm gonna decrease the font size right away to 14, and we're just gonna say group one. And I'm going to go ahead and position this exactly where I want it, and I'm gonna push Control D to duplicate that text box. I'm gonna position it to where I want it on that second series, and then I'm gonna push Control D again, and Control D one more time. Now this is pretty good, it aligns it pretty well once you do that, but I'm gonna go ahead and just nudge this down, and then I'm gonna hold down Shift and select all of these boxes. We're gonna just make sure that they are right aligned, and then we're gonna distribute them vertically equally. Perfect. And then you can go ahead and update the text for those boxes. 3 and 4. Perfect. Now, if you wanted there to be data labels here like we have right here, all you have to do is right-click, and we're going to isolate that data, that series, and say Add Data Label. And now you can see we've added a data label right here. Now, in the donut chart, there's no way to add to sort of change the position of the label, so you have to do that by dragging it down with your mouse. And I'm just going to position it there, and I'm going to add these labels for every single series, every single bar that we have, and just kind of position it where I think it works. And we're going to format these data labels in just a moment. Let's see, I'm going to add that data label so you can see them all right there. Now this first one right here, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to make it white, I'm going to make it bold, and then we're going to make that Open Sans Condensed again. Now what I'm going to do here is I want to apply this formatting to each of the other data labels. So I'm going to cut with that data label clicked, I'm going to go ahead up to the Format Painter right here, and I'm going to double click the Format Painter. When I do that, you can see this paintbrush icon appears. Anything that you click now should take the same formatting of this 95% data label. So I'm gonna go ahead and click the 50%, and you can see that formatting applies and that formatting applies. To unactivate that Format Painter, just go back and click it right there. Now that looks pretty good. You could probably just sort of nudge these or move these around a little bit. You can't nudge data labels in the same way that you can with text boxes using those over arrows, but you can just sort of click and drag just to make sure that everything is sort of in the right position that you want. And then once you do that, you can see that the labels also impact the size, the width of the bars. And so then you're gonna wanna go back and you're gonna wanna go and reposition the series labels right here. So we're gonna do that. I'm gonna make sure that this bottom one is aligned, and then I'm gonna make sure that this top one is aligned. And we'll go back and use our arrange tools to make sure that they're perfectly distributed. So we're gonna go back to the arrange, and then we're gonna distribute vertically. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. And if you wanted to just update the colors there, you could do that too. Looks like a pretty fun chart alternative to a traditional bar chart. I hope that you like this video. If you do, give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and hit the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. I had a great time making this for you, and I hope you had a great time watching it, and I hope you all have a fabulous weekend.